Hello, welcome to another episode of Recon-Deconstruction. I'm Chris, and we're going to be looking at Shrek the Musical today. I think it's a little one that is not all that popular for whatever reason, and I think more people need to know about it. So we're going to look specifically at a great song. I think it's got some of the best music in the entire score. You know, it's got a lot of eighth notes, a lot of seventh notes, sixth notes, fifth notes, fourth notes, any kind of notes you want, and called Donkey Pot Pie. All right, so at this point in the story, because I think it's important for you to know plot, the Shrek himself has gone to save the Princess Fiona, and they're in a castle of some sort, and Donkey, because he can't pay attention, gets lost, and he finds a dragon. And so, okay, so we're going to listen to the first part of this song. It's a really long song, too, so this will be a long video, I'm sorry. But so this first part here, I want you to be listening to the treble. There's a lot of treble going on at the opening of it, and you'll see. Hold on. Oh, wow. You didn't knock when you answered, baby. You didn't wipe your feet. Okay, we got to stop there. See, because he didn't wipe his feet. So that's so now we've got tension. See, now the genius of this Jeanine Tesori score here is that the lyric writer, Rabbit Hole Guy, has designed setup for the rest of the song. And this happens in 14 seconds. I mean, that's genius. So, okay, in this next part, I want you to listen to the vibrato. Listen to the vibrato. I mean, just wow. I think this is Haven Burton or somebody. Staccato. You need to brush up on fairy tales, friend, cause dragons like their sleep. Go on and grab some Okay, now it's going to jump the octave. I need you to listen to that. It's going to jump the octave not once, not twice, but three times. I think it's three times. Let's listen. Seven times. What do those lyrics mean? Now that's genius lyric writing right there, because that, not only now do we have tension, but we have plot. Do you understand that, folks? Okay, so in this next part of the song, what I need you to listen to is listen to all of the wibbly wobbly in the voice. That's what I like. It's going to go up and it's going to go a little wibbly wobbly, and you're going to hear some three quarter notes. I want you to listen specifically for those, because it's going to go tit-tit-tit-tit-tit-tit, but it's in the background and it's really low, so you're not going to be able to hear it that well, so you may have to crank it up a little bit, okay? All right. And it changes. It's like a whole different song. My, what big teeth you have. They're so sparkling white. I bet you hear this from all of your food, but you must beach at night. Is that a hint of minty freshness? Oh, I am scared to death. Donkey's scared. So now, not only do we have the exposition, a little bit of plot, some tension, but he's scared. Let's find out what happens next. I like a girl with a dazzling smile and tic-tac on her breath. Tic-tac. Oh, don't kill me. I don't know if you noticed, but there's a ukulele in the background. Lady with the pretty teeth. What's going to happen to Donkey? I don't know, but you had a dragon coming at him. And this is Broadway people, so I don't know if you know in the Broadway production, but they were actually dressed up, these women were dressed up as scales to the dragon, which was a huge head. And that's terrifying if you're three. I'm gonna love you. She's gonna love him. Huh? And take hold of you. Slow down, baby. How velvet gloves you. Velvet gloves me. My donkey hot. Listen to the phrasing on pie. It's like back phrasing, but not back phrasing, because they say it with the music. There's a lot going on here, I know, but what you got to pay attention to is the fact that they're saying a lot of stuff at the same time, and so some of the lyrics may be a little hard to hear. So I want you to listen in the background where you can hear Brian D'Arcy James asking what happened to his Tony. We had to close the note out a little early because I want you to listen to the very end of it when they're going to go a little bit up, uppity up. And you know what I mean by that, when they make like the sound that it's sort of like what birds make, like really large birds make when they're eating seed. And then like a seed gets stuck in the throat and then they like take it, they scoop up the octave. All right, listen. Genius. Brava Sondheim.